What's up guys, Pete here, and today I am back with another video, and this time I am playing Colin McRae Rally 04. So, for those of you who don't know, this is a several... That was a great start, wasn't it? This is a rally game that is obviously now 10 years old, as you can guess from the name, and I have just fallen off the road almost immediately. It was the penultimate game of the true Colin McRae Rally games. And it is one of the few games I have ever bought soon after launch and at pretty much full price. I paid 30 quid for it back in the day, and it came with 4 CDs because this was about a year before DVDs really began to take over. In fact, before DVDs really began to be used for computer gaming. I'm not doing anything majorly competitive here, I'm just driving some of the stages just to have a bit of fun. Driving the Citroen Zara. Now, if I remember correctly, Colin McRae was not driving. He wasn't driving full-time in 2004. He was, however, in 2003 in a Zara. So this was also the first game in a franchise for when McRae didn't have a full-time drive. The car choice in this game is not spectacular, unfortunately. It could really do with more cars, but it is what it is. Let's see. Running at pretty much a solid 120 frames per second. I've tweaked my settings a little bit so that frame drop should be less of an issue. And although there is still some, like when it happens, it's 120 down to 105. Which on a 60fps video should hopefully not be noticeable at all. So it's not quite lossless capture. I've also dropped down to stereo sound. I'm tweaking my microphone settings as well a little bit, and I'm just hoping that that all contributes to a much better experience for you guys. I'm sorry I haven't made any videos for a while. Been busy. It's just university work, society work. Look at that helicopter. And they've got a bit of a leg problem at the moment, which is causing me some discomfort, so I'm doing this with a keyboard. Hence why the driving is sort of a bit more consistent than normal. As you can see, the graphics are still pretty damn good. They're even better than the CMR 2.0s, although this game will not run at a resolution beyond 1280 by 960. At least, unless there's an official patch to do so. I haven't been looking for, which is a shame, because if this was running at full 1080p, this would still look absolutely brilliant even today. The car models are spot on, the car textures are pretty good, just like they are in CMR 2.0. Honestly, this and CMR 2.0, and probably CMR 3, although I can't remember off the top of my head, are probably some of the best scaling games that I've ever seen. Though this one runs a lot better than CMR 2.0, and that it's not up to 60 frames per second. I see sort of 400 plus, if you can believe it, most of the time on the stages when not recording. Whoops, got that wrong. But it also doesn't have the whacking rate frame drops in certain places that CMR 2.0 does. So, kudos for that. Nice going brakes at the end as well. So this game, yes, even today, 10 years on, this game still looks better than some far newer racing games. So, now we've left sunny Spain, and now we're in the forest of the UK. And again, it still looks very good. It's not quite to modern standards, of course, but it's still pretty damn good. Let's just keep carry on drifting around corners. I've already got a quick time on this stage set in, I think, this car, I'm not certain. One of the biggest issues with this game I have is the way the cheats worked, and it was a bit of cynical money-grabbing from Codemasters, something they weren't really prone to doing at the time. But basically, whereas all the previous games you could find all of the cheats online, CMR3, it started to move this way, but there were sort of like a fixed number of in-game codes, and you could keep resetting your game until you got one of the ones that had the best set of codes, cheat codes, that people leaked online. This one, I believe, had sort of individual cheat code setups for every game, and you could sort of message them for free at the time and get one or two, but then you sort of have to pay to actually get the rest, which was not really the spirit of things. In some ways it was sort of a bit of the pay to win stuff you see nowadays. And the only cheat codes I really that bothered about are sort of unlocking cars, unlocking tracks, because this game has some quite arbitrary systems for unlocking some of the cars as well. So you've sort of finished in various positions in the championships, but some of them sort of take quite a while. And the car choice isn't that great anyway. I mean, there's basically at the start you've got 4 2-wheel drive cars and 4 4-wheel drive cars, and that's it. And that's not great when you consider how much else there was out there. I mean, the 4-wheel drive cars at the start consisted of this, the Focus, the Subaru Impreza, and Mitsubishi Lancer. There is no Peugeot, you have to unlock that. And sort of none of the, whoops, there's no sort of shoehorning in the old, well, the Skoda Fabia, which there was being used in 2004. In fact, McRae actually would go on to drive it, but this game was actually made over free, I would imagine. I'm really not driving very well. Whoops! Oops. But you know, there would certainly, the Fabia would fit. And then putting in the older sort of Octavia and the Leon and Leon Certset Toledo, I think it was. No, it was Cordoba that was used in this. Cordoba would have been nice. Having the Hyundai accent, maybe. I know they weren't rallying at the time, but it would still be nice to actually have some more. But it's the 2-wheel drive that really sort of lacks. If I remember correctly, there's a Polo which you have to unlock, the Fiat Punto, the Ford Puma, and the Citroen Saxo, is it? I'm not sure, but there's so many. I mean, they're just Super 1600 cars as well. There's no 2-litre front-wheel drive cars or anything like that, which is a shame. There's quite a few. A good choice was about 5 Group B cars as well. All the usual suspects there, if I remember correctly. And then there's a few bonus cars. So there's an older Impreza, there's a Transit Van, I'm just trying to remember what else there is. I honestly can't remember. There's an MGB, I can remember that, but it's just not particularly impressive, given what other games could offer at this time. The car fits, it's pretty decent, they're pretty standard, Colin McRae fare. Perfectly playable with a keyboard or a wheel, if you're good enough to use a wheel to rally game, which in itself is quite a talent. Now I'm now at the Acropolis Rally. If you can still find a copy of this, I strongly suggest you go and pick it up. It still runs perfectly on Windows 7 64-bit. It runs as smoothly. It won't run, it runs at reasonable frame rates on my crappy laptop, which is an achievement in itself, unless I put AA on, but that's just because that laptop is hilariously weak. Even in terms of CPU power, this game is definitely worth picking up, and it's sort of one of the last of the, it's the penultimate one of the true Colin McRae Rally games before they got dirt-sized. I like dirt games, I quite like them, but there are definitely people who don't, and there are definitely calls for this sort of thing to return, particularly as there is no real asset reuse, and that's what gets me about dirt, that's what gets me about the WRC official games, and various other ones at the moment, is that they have 6 stages, they're all fairly short, and sort of 3 minutes, and yet they all sort of reuse assets to the point where they often end up with half the stages being just reruns of the you get 3 stages and then you get 3 the other way around. There's no excuse for it, it's just lazy. When games like this could have 6 stages that look great, certainly for the time, but even now they still look good, when you can have 6 stages which was often longer than those sounded dirt free for that as well. They wouldn't be reusing assets, and in fact they'd be totally different stations in some of the events. it's just ridiculous. There's no excuse for it. And it's something that I really miss is a proper rally game that isn't entirely WRC focused necessarily. This one obviously is, and I've just rolled the car, obviously. But it's just, I would really like to have something, you know, something more. And the WRC games are good, but they're not great. Not by any stretch of imagination, the stage length is what we desired. Which is why I still maintain that the Mobile 1 Rally Championship is one of the best rally games of all time. Because it has those really long stages. You know, what the game should offer is the ability to have, sort of, if you want to do a 3-minute stage, it's fine. Give them 3-minute segments, the best sort of 3-minute segments of a stage, but if they want to play the full 15-20 minute stages, give them that option. It wouldn't require that much effort to go and do that. I'm now in America, by the way. That's the other thing this game offered, is some unusual rallies. I mean, how many games have got Rally Japan and Rally US in? Not many. So I do miss the proper rally games. And again, we used to have so many rally games, you know. There were a whole bunch of them that were loosely WRC based on the PS2. And obviously there were then the ones like Colin McRae Rally, Richard Burns ones, WRC games, Rally Championship, Rally Evolved, and had V-Rally, which wasn't great, but was passable in the later games. The first one's a park crap, and I would strongly advise don't go anywhere near it. It's just got some of the worst physics ever. I mean, back in the 1990s, there were a huge amount of rallying-based games, and they've just gone. I mean, racing games in general have had a massive decline, and frankly, it's hard to see why. Not like the market share's gone down, but the games that we are getting are just a shadow of what they once were. I mean, Gran Turismo 6 was full of assets that went back to Gran Turismo 3 and 4, which was unacceptable. Forza has become a DLC-filled, microtransaction-filled mess. Forza 4 is great, but Forza 5, as far as I can tell, and certainly Forza Horizons as well, I believe, are full of microtransactions and all that. And they're also console exclusives, which means that they're inherently handicapped by the consoles they're on. So it's just a real shame. I mean, Forza 4 is a great looking Xbox 360 title, but it would look a mile better if it were on the PC. I miss Microsoft making games for their consoles and the PC. Whoops! As you can see, the damage model is reasonably impressive on this game. And this is with it on normal, so you turn it to heavy. I mean, look at that rear spoiler. It's one of the better damage models there ever been. Perhaps it's a bit more arcadey and exaggerated, but in terms of the amount of damage on it, look at the amount of far newer games that don't do anything like this. Well, even sort of, I mean, let's compare it to Race 07, 3 or 4 years down the line, not look anything this good, like this good, in terms of damage and such things. Okay, so now we're going to Sweden. So now we have snow. The people leave a little bit to be desired, although I will go out and say that they look far better than they do in some games where people are supposedly the focus to some degree. Like, I don't know, Roller Coaster Tycoon 3. Those peeps were awful. I really need to get around to playing Colin McRae Rally 05. I never have. It's a bit of a travesty when I owned everything bar Dirt 2 and Colin McRae Rally 05. Now, I own Colin McRae Rally 3 on the PS2 and the PC, and that had 3 CDs. It's see over the crest. And whoops! No, it's not going to that hut. Oh man. It's just, I long for the days when racing games were a staple of video games. It's weird because there weren't anywhere near as many FPSs back then. It's almost like the racing game genre has been replaced by the FPS in terms of oversaturation. And the racing games we're left with nowadays, I mean, Need for Speed has become a caricature of what it used to be. I mean, Need for Speed on Pro Street started the rot. Undercover was an inherently broken game, and it had a really bad plot, and it didn't even look that good. Again, let's come back to the graphics argument. You compare the graphics of Need for Speed Undercover to this, and this wipes a floor with it 5 years before. It's just ridiculous. Oh, brakes. Got sucked into that and just got out the way with it. Seriously, I hope the audio doesn't glitch out in this video, which may be quite a long video, but we shall see. Oh man, from the brakes into the corner. Some of these tracks are still in my muscle memory, some of them aren't. Ooh, dancy. That was too much into that corner. Ooh, we got away with it though. Look at all these trees. Just missed the times when racing the game for king. There's just no reason why they can't make good ones, but they just seem to have stopped doing it. Ooh, off-road. Now, is this the penultimate stage that I'm running on, about to go on, or is it the final one? I think it's the final one. Yep, I'm now in finish, so I think this is the final one. And off we go. I mean, there are newer games generally that don't have textures that work much up to this sort of sound. Very, very impressive. I don't know how they managed it, but they have. Into the corner, and here we go. High speed. I'm also playing this with the sound off to try and minimise any potential feedback through the microphone, so I'm literally going based on the arrows rather than what the co-driver actually says. Or basically what I can see on the road in front of me as well. Right, over the crest. Whoa, sparks fly. And let's hit the full speed through here. Look how fast I'm going. This is going to end badly. And on the brakes hard. And through there. And into the ditch. Because this stage is full of ditches that I generally manage to find. Where am I going? See, that arrow wasn't helpful. Kick out the backside of the car. Just bring back racing games as they used to be. And cuts. Also, what really annoys me are when games are so heavily against you cutting that they will block you from taking that line, even though a real rally driver would have taken that line. Yes, WRC is official game. I am looking directly at you because you are very bad at doing it. Uh-oh. Tree. So, I mean, I've seen sort of a tyre that sort of punctured and hasn't fallen straight off the rim, and you can see that quite clearly on some of them. It's really nice. Back. People. Whoa. I'm doing well here. The glasses come off. Got no rear window. I can see the driver. Whee. I made an Airfix car of an Airfix kit, one of these cars, years and years ago. Obviously, it's long since disintegrated as it was an Airfix kit, but it was always impressive just how dependable the Zara was. Because the road cars weren't particularly, but it was fast and it was reliable and it was durable as well. And in the hands of Sebastian Lowe, there was very little that would touch it, particularly when it was on full form. No, I mean, it didn't help that Ford were not really doing anything until they finally signed Ronholm. They went to the doldrums, Subaru went backwards with car issues, Mitsubishi were well since gone.
and Peugeot were going backwards with a quick but unreliable 307. Anyway, that concludes this video. If you enjoyed, please leave a like, comment, and if you're new to my channel, please subscribe. Maybe share my videos, it would really help me out. So yeah, I hope to see you back here in the very near future with more videos, and look out, and wishing you a good day.